G'day, my name's Pete and welcome to the Thaguna Golf Club. Thaguna is a suburb just outside of Albury, which is in New South Wales, Australia. We've got a very special visitor that's come to visit us this year. He lives out on this dam behind me. It's a very rare bird indeed. So without further ado, let's go and have a look at him.
Now in Australia, our wood ducks, or they're also known as a Maine duck, I understand, typically sort of a grey and a black. They've got a bit of a green fleck. The male's got a green fleck on his wing, which is pretty iridescent. If you look at that picture, there's two males in the foreground and there's a couple of hens in the background, which sort of their colours aren't as distinct. But we had a very special wood duck fly in here about 3 weeks ago, and he's taken up residence. He's actually looking for a mate, but nobody's interested in him, and I think you'll know why when you see him. There he is there. We've actually named him Warwick the White Wood Duck. He's sort of been hanging around in these packs of ducks, and he's been looking for a mate, but so far he hasn't had much success. We think it's because he sort of gets a bit shunned because he's a, he's a bit unique. When we were working out what sort of, what we'd call him, me and one of the greenkeepers down here, Timmy, I sort of came up with the name Michael Jackson, but, oh, there he goes there. He's having a bit of a stretch. But if you look closely on these ducks, that mane on the back of that duck's neck, so that's why they sort of get that nickname, Maned Duck, M-A-N-E. Now Warwick, as he's affectionately known, has there he goes, just having a bit of a flap. But he's also got one mate here. Now this is Hopalong. He's pretty unique. He's got one leg. I don't know what happened to the other one. He sort of hangs out here a bit with Warwick, the White Wood Duck. And a bit later on, I'm going to fetch him into the water so that we can prove that a one-legged duck does not swim in circles. There's Hopalong. He's got quite a unique way of getting along. I suppose it's the only way he can, and that's just hopping along. But more of a bit of Warwick, if I just sort of give him a bit of a shoo into the shot there, I think he'll be... Now they're heading towards the dam, which is there in the background. So far this year, last year Warwick the White Wood Duck turned up and he stayed for about a week. They don't know where he went during that time, but it tends to be around duck season that he keeps coming back here. Probably because it's a bit of a safe haven for him, I suppose. He knows that people aren't going to shoot at him. The only thing he could suffer here is probably being hit by a golf ball. Now I'm just going to follow Hopalong here into the water, because I really want to see if a one-legged duck does swim in circles. There he goes. Well, he's not going in the water, is he? There he is. He's coming in for a landing. And there he landed. Bit of a rough landing, but as you can see, the one-legged duck swims straight. Amazing. So as you can see, Warwick has, he is actually a real, he's not an albino, because otherwise he'd have pink. Sorry about the panning on this. Tripod's a bit stiff. he is a genuine wood duck, or main duck, whatever you prefer. He just wants to sort of fit in there. The other ducks have sort of taken him under his wing, so to speak, but still, Warwick appears to be the only one who is yet to find a mate. When I first saw Warwick was when I was playing an actual round of golf, and I pulled up and said, "Hello, look, there's a house duck, or a peking duck, or whatever they call those wild ones." And then I took a closer look and just noticed that mane on him and thought, that's a white bloody wood duck. When I came back with my camera, for ages I'd be chasing him around because he was just so shy and timid. He was always the one that would run to the furthest of the pack and wouldn't let me get close to him at all. But now, it's a different story. He's become quite relaxed with me, and I can get stills of him. I can walk up with my other camera and get quite close, within about 3 or 4 metres. And he'll just go on eating and ignoring me. And as you can see now, I'm about 7 metres away from him, and he's nearly thinking about having a sleep. So I don't want to get him too relaxed, otherwise he might suffer the fate of something else. They're up very early in the morning, those fellas, around 5 o'clock. So understandably, they need their little bit of kip.
There's a little white duck sitting in the water, a little white duck doing what he oughter. He took a bite of a lily pad, flapped his wings, and he said, "I'm glad I'm a little white duck sitting in the water. Quack, 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 quack." There's a little green frog swimming in the water, a little green frog doing what he oughter. He jumped right off of the lily pad that the little duck bit, and he said, "I'm glad I'm a little green frog swimming in the water. Glump, 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 glump." There's a little black bug floating on the water, a little black bug doing what he oughter. He tickled the frog on the lily pad that the little duck bit, and he said, "I'm glad I'm a little black bug floating on the water. Chirps, chirps, chirps." There's a little red snake laying in the water, a little red snake doing what he oughter. He frightened the duck and the frog so bad, he ate the little bug, and he said, "I'm glad I'm a little red snake laying in the water. Wriggles, wriggles, wriggles." Now there's nobody left sitting in the water, nobody left doing what he oughter. There's nothing left but the lily pad. The duck and the frog ran away. I'm sad 'cause there's nobody left sitting in the water. Boo, hoo,